clearance and creepage. When it comes to voltage differences, you treat DC and AC a bit differently. With DC, you base the clearance on the potential difference between the two DC voltages. But with AC, you use the RMS, or root mean square, values. And with AC, you also need to consider relative phase. Creepage rules are often a mixture of external and internal standards, so you can set those rules at a hierarchy of levels, both within designs themselves and in reusable design rules, giving maximum flexibility in applying and checking standards. Here are those levels. Whole board level. Differential pair class level. Differential pair level. ENET class level. ENET level. NET class level. NET level. Rule area level, like maybe the area around this 90 volt biased avalanche diode array. Or as fully structured, reusable voltage difference clearance tables. These can be based on external standards or your own standards. The way you use them doesn't change. Okay, let's set up a voltage difference clearance table. I'm just setting up clearances for up to and beyond 90 volts, but I could equally be entering a table of voltage difference clearances for a standard like IPC221A. And I can share this table with any other engineers I choose to share it with, without the need to share any of the other design rules, unless, of course, I choose to do so. So now I'll set that voltage difference clearance table as a design rule in Constraint Browser. It's called table stack because you can stack them up in a hierarchy, but in this case there's just one. It's DC, so I don't have to worry about any phase relationships. So the rule's defined, the rule's assigned, let's check it. The check gets made for whatever I select. And since I'm interested in a 2mm clearance, I'm going to tell the check not to search any more than 4mm out from that selected object. The check's found an issue, a 95 volt voltage difference with less than 2mm clearance. I'll just cross-probe that onto the canvas so we can see where it is. And since this is a 3D creepage check, let's view it in 3D. That'll become more important in just a moment. The 3D clearance fail I just cross-probed shows up as this line connecting the two objects. I'm going to cut a slot in the PCB. I've turned off other clearance checks and played very fast and loose with them to illustrate what the creepage check can do. This time I'm selecting the minus 5 volts net in the 3D view from Constraint Browser. But when I run the check again, I can see that the minus 5 volts and the plus 90 volts are still very slightly too close together. The path around the end of the slot is still just a little too short. So I'll just move that slot slightly. And now when I rerun the creepage check, the clearance is okay. But as well as lengthening or blocking a creepage path, a hole or slot can create one, like this path between layers 1 and 8, detected by the creepage check. With eCADSTAR's creepage checks, you aren't artificially constrained by 2D clearances. You design in real-world 3D, meaning you can optimize performance and density.